Hey guys, today is my 44th birthday. Not sure if it's a celebration or not. And I have been working on a project today, which is putting together this new guitar, the components of which were presents for my birthday. When I'm writing songs, I find it's a really good source of inspiration to kind of write on new instruments. So I'm always looking for new variants of things to play with for that. And we've been listening to Folklore, Taylor Swift's album that she put out over lockdown, a lot the last year, and also watched the video of the live sessions that went with it that was on Disney Plus. And that's where I saw these particular guitars that have this particular sound with these very deadened strings, rather than ringing out, which I thought sounded really cool. There's a bit in the video where Aaron Dessner, who's one of the guys who worked with Taylor Swift on it, talks about the guitar and where it came from.
I remember when I bought this little guitar that has a rubber bridge, which you have one now too, but
you sent it to me, and it was like, I couldn't believe opening up this like beautiful, isn't it a 50s guitar?
It is from the late 50s, and wow. It's been like renovated so that the bridge deadens the strings and it sounds really old, and it's just a really kind of writes songs for you in a way. Because mm-hmm. It's so fun to play. Mm-hmm.
So obviously the idea of writing songs for you, great. So I thought this would be a great thing to have and to work on. Did a little bit more digging around. I found a Reddit thread that linked to a tweet that Aaron Dessner had made about some of these things. Got a little bit more information, so I'll put some links to that stuff in the description. But basically, what I figured out is that they are the guitars they're using are old kind of 50s vintage guitars. Now I'm not going to shell out for one of those, but they're Parlour guitars, so they're smaller than full size guitars. The guy in question who did them fits them with these rubber bridges that deaden the strings, like Aaron mentions in the video. So I decided to have a go at making one of these myself. It hasn't been a hugely time-consuming job. This has all been done today, and I've been doing other stuff as well. And it hasn't been massively expensive either. This is a pretty cheap acoustic that came from Gear for Music. Strip of rubber for the bridge here, and this string saddle here was also needed. So all in all, it was not a great deal more than 100 quid. I'll put some links to the stuff I used in case anybody's interested. So I've been working on that today. The rest of this video is basically showing how I took the guitar that I ordered and made this bridge to get the sound. And I think it's pretty successful. So I'm pretty happy with it. So what I've got here is a new guitar that I've ordered. This is a relatively inexpensive acoustic guitar that came from Gear for Music. And it's a Parlour guitar, which is a slightly smaller scale length. I think it's somewhere around it might be a bit bigger than a 3/4 size. Anyway, smaller than a normal guitar, which is the same size of guitar that were customized and used in the Taylor Swift video. So those were vintage 50s Parlour guitars, and this is something a little bit more basic, but to get the tone as similar as possible, I'm using one of those, and they're also a bit cheaper, so I feel better about pulling it apart. Other things I've got here, I've got a tailpiece, which is going to go on the back here, and the strings are going to attach into that. And I've got some thick rubber strap, which I'm going to use to make the rubber bridge. The general idea is that we replace this normal bone bridge here with a strip of rubber. And I'm going to need to cut that into the right shape to get the intonation right on the guitar. It's going to be wider than a normal bridge, and the strings are going to run over it, and then the rubber damps the strings and gives it that sort of clunky sound that's what we're looking for. Because it's a wider bridge, these pegs that hold the strings in are going to be covered up. And also I want the strings to kind of lay flat over the rubber bridge so they get damped properly. So that's the reason for having this behind here, the idea being that then the strings run from this over the bridge. Now, having got this, it's a little bit bigger than I expected, or probably the reality is this guitar's a bit smaller than you might expect. So if I put it on the way it's supposed to go, this comes quite a long way forwards and is going to be very close to where the bridge is, and I want it a little bit further back. I don't know if you can see that there's a bend in the metal plate here. So what I'm planning on doing is actually trying to flatten that out so that that is where it connects, and then it will be something like this on the body, so that it is a little bit further back. And I think that will help the strings lay flat over the rubber bridge and make sure they get that damped sound. So there's mostly there. There's some screw holes, it screws into the back there, as you might expect. So the first thing I need to do is take the strings and the old bridge off, so I'll do that now. Okay, first thing I'm going to try, or the next thing I'm going to try, is I'm going to try and bend this plate here to be straight. I'm going to put some card around it so that so the pliers don't damage the metal too much. Try that on the back of the guitar. To do that, I'm going to need to take this nut off. Yeah, that sits pretty snugly. That's worked the way I wanted it to. And I think as a bonus, this bottom hole here is going to line up with the tuning peg, so it'll be an extra fixing there for it. Not tuning peg, strap button. Okay, so the next step then is to create the rubber bridge piece that's going to go in here. So it's going to be a section of rubber strap that goes across like that. Going to put it along the same line as the existing bridge, and also use the measurements of the string positions, or the point where the string vibrates from on the existing bridge. So that's already been worked out for this guitar, so the tuning is about right. So then if I take those same measurements, then it should work successfully with the rubber bridge. So I'm going to get that marked up, and then I'll come back when I'm ready to cut out the shapes. So what I've got here is I've got the bridge, the original bridge from the guitar, and there's the little sort of notches in it where the strings pass over it. So I've marked those with a pencil, and I'm now going to match those up, make a mark on the rubber strip at the same point where those go across. So that gives me the positions where the strings will need to cut across the rubber bridge once they're in place. So I've trimmed the edges of this piece of rubber strap off, and I've marked out on here the shape that I can see on the bridge from the original guitar. Here's a close-up of the rubber marked out, ready to cut, compared with the old bridge. So now I'm going to cut that piece of rubber away using a knife. It's not too bad. Take a little bit more off of that from lower down, just to make sure that it's not going to interfere with the string. And the same here. I think that looks about right. So I've used the knife to cut in the shape of the bridge here, and originally I was going to score underneath here and sort of hollow out the underneath so it had a lip that would hook on there. On reflection, I think that's going to be really difficult to keep even, and I don't want it to be bumpy and the strings not to sit properly. So what I've done is I've cut another thin strip of rubber, which I'm going to put in there, and I'm just going to glue that to the bottom edge of that. And while I'm here, I've also just kind of sketched out here the shape of the bridge. So I'm going to trim down the rubber so that it looks neat. Okay, so I've cut a thin slither of rubber that's going to go in there, and I've also masked the area because the glue I'm going to use, I want to make sure it doesn't stick to the rest of the guitar. So I'll slide that into there. And then what I'm going to do is glue that on there. And obviously I need to be sure that I'm getting this the right way around. So I'm giving a Gorilla Glue a go here. I'm going to put out some onto this bit of scrap paper. Way more than I needed, but I'm just going to put it on with a cocktail stick. Looks pretty good. Edge, make sure that's there, and then I'm going to put a heavy weight on it to hold it in place while it sticks. Right, so I've now got this cut to more or less the right shape, and this is the glue is set on this. That fits in there pretty neatly. The next thing I'm going to do then is go attaching this. So I'm going to start by just putting the strap button back on through this. Thing for marking the spot where the screws can go in.
just to get the screws started. We've got the screws that came with hardware. The next thing I need to do is cut some little grooves into the rubber here. That's gonna where it's gonna hold the string in place. It's where it's gonna be seated across the rubber. So what I'm going to do, I've taped the bridge in place here centrally, so it doesn't move. And I'm now going to draw a straight line from where the edge of the where the string should be coming out of the front of the bridge based on the old bridge to the entry point where the string will be secured here. Just comparing that to the old bridge, just to make sure those are definitely in the right place. Those look about right. So the next thing I need to do is going to cut the grooves for the strings to rest in. And I'm going to do that using some lino cutting tools, which are, I think are going to work quite well for the job. Okay, so this is the lino cutting tool I'm going to use to make the groove in the rubber. I don't know if you can see on here, there's a number of different shape cuts you can make. So I'm using number one, which gives this very narrow groove, which I think should be right to hold the string in place. I'm going to make the grooves a little bit deeper for thicker strings. Just going over these front edges to make sure that there's a really nice groove for the string to seat itself in. At the front there, where it really needs to stick. So hopefully you can see those grooves I've cut in there now. Not 100% sure if they're definitely going to be deep enough, but we will try stringing the guitar and see how it sounds. Okay, so now I'm going to restring the guitar. I've still got the strings that I took off, but because the way I've hooked up this bridge, the length of string now needs to be slightly longer, so I am going to put a new set of strings on. I'm going to put some electric strings on, largely because at some point going forwards, if this thing sounds okay, I want to put a pickup in here, and the bronze strings don't work so well with that, so this will be ready to go for that. Also, these happen to be what I've got kicking around. So, when I'm stringing a guitar, I don't know if this is normal stuff or this is what everyone does, I put on the outer two strings first, just like a guide. Thank you. So here I'm noticing that the sound wasn't quite as muted as I was hoping it would be. So then I am cutting a deeper groove into the rubber so that the string is fully embedded in it. I used a knife for the thinner strings and the Lino tool to make a slightly wider groove for the thicker strings. Try taking a bit more out with this. That's a bit better. It's a bit more like the dead sound I'm expecting. The same for the other strings. Close-up of the bridge with all the strings embedded in the rubber. Okay, so I've adjusted that then so that each of the strings is slightly embedded in the rubber bridge, and that seems to have given the right sort of sound. So to the Taylor Swift sound, so I think that has been very successful. So hopefully that was useful, interesting. Maybe if you're interested in making a guitar with a similar sound, that could be useful. If you do that, then let me know. I'd love to hear about it. I guess I'll be back soon with a shed load of songs that this thing is gonna auto write for me. See you then. Bye. Thank you.